man gives up his seat for blind man. Right? You would conclude that that man that gave up his seat to the blind man is a good man, right?
That's right, yes.
But until I tell you more of the story, see, the man that gave up his seat to the blind man was the bus driver. He's not a good man, he's an evil man because he put everybody's life in jeopardy, right?
Right.
So the reason why you can draw a better conclusion is because you know more of the story.
Right.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
But half of the story, you only draw a limited conclusion. As a matter of fact, you can draw an unwise conclusion based on half of the story.
Yeah,
makes sense?
Yes.
So here's what I want to show you guys about more of the story about God himself. All right? So based on what the Bible says, would you consider yourself to be a good person? Just based on, okay?
Yes.
All right? How did you arrive at this standard?
I'm going to be honest. I was raised in church.
Okay.
So I believe in what Jesus said, which is love God and love your neighbor as yourself.
Gotcha. I hope you guys live to be 200 years old.
I do too.
But if the day happened to be the last day you stood before God, I don't know if you knew this statistic, but 150,000 people die every single 24 hours. And most people never think about where they're going to spend the majority of their time.
No.
So if you were to stand before God, tell me briefly, why do you think he would let you into heaven?
Well, I personally feel like I've sinned a lot. And I personally feel like I do wrong, and I am a sinner every day. But when I accepted God into my heart, I meant it, and I know what I said. And when I asked him to be my Savior, I feel like that I know that I meant it in the right intentions and the right way. And I feel like, yes, I do mess up every day, and I do ask for forgiveness.
As a non-religious person, if that was to happen, I was standing before God.
Yeah, why do you think he let you in today?
Just off of the people that are around me that I not do things for. That's not why I'm a good person. But I would do anything for any of my people, regardless of anything.
Yep.
I do believe I live a good life.
Okay.
Because I will help other people. I will do other things.
Okay.
Forgiving as it is taught, because I believe that I'm living a good life.
Okay.
And right. I hope that I've done enough to impress him.
I've done the best I could with my life.
Sure.
I've lived it the best I know how. I've done.
Yeah.
I've tried to do right by most people.
Sure.
Never tried to wrong anybody.
Sure.
But in the end, it's going to be his decision.
It's going to be,
A different answer. To
sure.
To be brutally honest, I do not think I would make it in.
Good answer. I think that's a good answer.
But I would be completely okay with that.
Okay.
Knowing, I don't want to say standards, but knowing what God's standards are.
Sure.
I'm big statement, but I don't think anybody meets those standards to a full 100%.
You said this. Matter of fact, I was going to give you guys the standard.
Yeah.
Before you leave, I'll give you the standard to give you more of the story.
Okay.
Here's the standard. The standard is the Ten Commandments, okay? Now here's a statement that y'all going to probably disagree with, but then let me explain.
Go ahead.
In order for you to get into heaven, you actually have to be absolutely completely perfect. Now let me tell you why. Take your favorite drink in the world, and I took a drop of sewage and put it in your drink. You wouldn't drink it.
Absolutely not.
Yeah. Right? Because one drop will contaminate the entire rest of your drink. Well, the Bible says God is so spotless and so holy. Allow one of your sins into his presence, it'll corrupt heaven. He wants everything to be perfect around him, or he will cease to be perfect.
Oh, correct.
That makes sense? So here's the standard. How many lies have you told in your whole life? No judgment. I'm not judging you guys. I'm right there with you.
A lot.
What do you call somebody that tell a lot of lies?
A lot, right?
Yeah. Have you ever stolen anything, even if it's small?
Sure. I actually have not ever stolen anything.
Never stolen it? You ever cheat?
I've never stolen anyone from anything.
Have you ever cheated on a test and stolen answers?
No.
Yeah. Wow.
I've cheated on tests.
I'm not gonna lie.
I've cheated on tests.
Yeah, so we stole answers.
Okay. I'll make good college grades.
I've never stolen physically anything. And I've never cheated on a test. Obviously, there's something I'm not thinking about because everyone is wrong at some point.
You are a good guy, right?
But those two things specifically I've never done.
All right, now here's what's going to get all of us. It's going to nail all of us to the wall.
I'm ready.
Jesus said it. If you look at someone with lust, you commit adultery in your heart. Have you ever had sex out of marriage, watch pornography?
All right. I'm going to turn around and look at my
Guilty, right? Yeah. Have you ever used God's name as a cuss word?
Yes.
Did y'all know that in the Old Testament, to use God's name in vain was like punishable by death?
Yes. Absolutely.
Got it? All right. Here's another one. Have you ever been angry with somebody? You almost feel like you could, like, over in your mind, you hurt him in your mind, repent, or trying to kill him in your mind, right?
Yeah.
You know what the Bible equates that with?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Murder. Yeah. Murder. Even thinking, if you think it in your heart, the Bible says you're guilty.
Yes.
So y'all see this standard that none of us can keep?
Correct.
Right?
Correct.
So if God was a good judge, you take an earthly judge has to punish the murderer or the child molester.
Yes.
If the murderer or the child molester tried to pay that judge off and that judge accepted the payment and let that murderer or that child molester walk, what kind of judge would he be?
Corrupt
judge. So do you see that if God is good, that he can't let you in and he has to give you what you deserve?
Absolutely.
Does that make sense?
That's what I'm so content with.
Yes.
All right?
I am also content with that. Correct. Yes.
Right. So I put my trust in the goodness of God instead of my own goodness and choose to turn from what got me in the situation I'm in, choose to give up my sin as best I know how, but I transfer my goodness to the goodness of God.
If that means that I need to be in hell, then so be it. I will be in hell.
But see, that's the good part about Jesus. Jesus already went to hell for you when he went on the cross.
That is very true.
So he don't want you to go to hell. He wants you to live for him. And if you will repent and put your faith in him, kind of like you trust a parachute, right? Because think about it. If you think about it, most people try to save themselves by, let's just say all of us get up on a plane, 10,000 feet in the air. Let's say, hey, guys, we got to jump. And I want you to flap your arms as hard as you can. I don't care how hard you try to flap your arms, you're not going to save yourself.
I ain't jumping out of that plane.
Well, we all are going to swing out into eternity at some point.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you try your best all your life to try to be good enough to try to flap your arms and try to save yourself and try not to cuss and try not to do all these, keep the standard, you will never be able to make it.
Try not to drink.
All right. So, yeah, right.
There it is.
But if you would transfer yourself from your trust to the Savior like you trust a parachute, you put on a parachute. The parachute takes you 8 miles to the ground instead of you trying to flap your arms going 120 miles to the ground. Well, Jesus is the parachute. It's a gift that you don't deserve, but he loves you enough to give it to you. So if you repent and you will believe, God will promise to give you eternal life. And he will start a relationship with you, even right here where you're standing. Knowing that you could die tomorrow, and I'm not trying to scare you guys, because fear is your friend.
To be honest, you changed my perspective a little bit.
Really?
Yeah.
I gave you more of the story.
Perspective, but my perspective is altered.
You gave us
more. I gave you more of the story that I didn't know for a long time.
Yes.
He's a gracious, loving God, and he has to punish sin. People say, like, why does bad things happen to good people? Well, the Bible says nobody's good. So we all actually deserve more punishment. This is the whole hope of the whole world. So it answers those four questions. It answers the first question we talked about. One, where does man came from? Well, you guys said it. God created the world. Well, what's man's purpose? Our purpose is to ultimately give God glory with our life. That's our ultimate purpose for you. And like if you made a sculpture, you'll want everybody to look at that sculpture, and they will give you credit for the sculpture. Not giving credit to the sculpture. That makes sense?
Yeah.
The credit goes to you that made the sculpture. Well, God created you, so you can give him credit and glory. That'll be your ultimate happiness, is to make God smile, right?
Yes.
So that answers the second question. Your purpose is to give God glory. The third question is, why is the world so messed up? The third question is, because man sinned. You said, I think some of you guys were saying it. We all went our own way. God has a standard.
You said free will.
Free will? You hit it on the head.
All of us.
We went our own way. God has a standard, and we went to opposite directions. That's why our world is broken, right? And men will try to fix it by using four ways. They'll try to fix their brokenness. One is we'll run towards relationships. We'll try to use other people to fix it. Sexual relationships. If my daddy would treat me better, if I able to fit in.
Yep.
We run towards riches. We try to accumulate all these things, but some of the most miserable people in the world are rich.
Amen.
Right?
Absolutely. Money is not happiness.
Man. No! And ultimately, that is satisfying. We have a God-shaped hole in our heart, and the only one that can fill it is you. Alright? The other thing being trying to run to is religion. Religion don't even save you. Matter of fact, you know, the type of people that put Jesus on the cross was religious people.
Yes.
So even Jesus don't like religion.
Yes.
He wants a relationship. Right? The other thing people try to use to try to fix their brokenness, you really good, is they run towards. But the only way we can fix it is through Jesus. The only fix is Jesus. Fixing Jesus. So we're talking about purpose, origin, purpose. Why is the world messed up? And the only fix is who? It's Jesus. That answers those four questions. So y'all got anything else to add to that? What do y'all think?
I think you changed my mind on a lot.
Seriously?
100%.
Really? What makes you say that?
When I think it's I got it from this. And this is probably painfully obvious to a lot of people, but we spend our entire lives trying to be good and do good and in hopes that we can, enter the pearly gates. But that man died so that we, literally died so we wouldn't have to worry about that. He's like, no, I got it,
Yeah.
And here we are, and the only thing think we're worried about saving our own tails.
Woo! He's already faith saved us, man.
That's just kind of like that. That's what I gathered from that.
Isn't that good? If you had to put it on a red light, says, man, I don't want to follow Jesus. I'm not doing good right now. Yellow light says, let me think about this. Let me think about this for a while before I really like jump in and start following Jesus.
Oh yeah.
The other one is, man, knowing what I know now, I'm ready to repent and I'm ready to follow Jesus. Even with the little bit that I know now.
Yeah.
What do you guys say, y'all at? Red, yellow, or green?
I'm a brutally honest person. Yellow.
Yellow, good word.
Say yellow.
Yellow, okay.
Can I take a caveat here and go orange?
Okay, what makes you say orange?
It's not do not believe.
Sure.
But like I can be shown and persuaded to follow. So red, yellow,
gotcha.
Or orange. Like it's right. It's I don't want to be so like
sure.
black and white on
I got you, bro.
But the most I've got out of this is whenever I was saved and I'm falling short of God, I feel like I can never go back.